Hello, it's Mike from Pixivu. Today, you will learn how to convert these flat shapes and text into a realistic 3D neon effect. At the end of the tutorial, you will be able to update the neon text completely with a single click. Please like the video and let's get started. This video is sponsored by Wondershare DemoCreator, a screen recorder and video editor simplified for all. Record your own video tutorials, presentations, and games. Edit them like a pro using the powerful captions, annotations, stickers, transitions, and more. I really like this green screen removal tool. You can use it to remove your chroma background or just replace it for some video compositing. Unleash your creativity and start using Wondershare DemoCreator today. Download it for free from the description below. Now, let's get back to our tutorial. Create the neon text. Let's select the main layer and duplicate it 9 times with Ctrl J. Rename them from bottom to top. Base 1, base 2, base 3. Glass 1, glass 2, glass 3. And finally, light 1, 2, and 3. Hide all layers. Then select all 9 layers by holding the Shift key. Drag and drop on the group icon to group them. Name it Neon. Each layer of these 9 layers will get some styling to form the final neon effect. Now, leave base 1 layer as it is. And just add some styling to the base 2 layer. Just unhide it and double-click to open its layer style window. Select Inner Shadow. Change color to white. Blend mode to normal. Opacity to 50%. Angle to 90 degrees. Distance to 10 pixels. Choke to 20%. And finally, size to 70 pixels. Select also Drop Shadow. Change color to black. Blend mode to multiply. Opacity to 45%. Angle to 90. Distance to 40. Spread 0 and size 40. And please uncheck this option. Layer knocks out drop shadow. Now open blending options and decrease fill to 0%. This will hide the main layer and keep its layer style visible. We should go through these styling steps for all 9 layers, but to save your time, I just made them for you. You will find the download link in the description below. Now hide base 2 layer and unhide base 3. Double-click it to open its layer style. Click on Styles, and let's import our neon styles. If you point over each one of them, you will see their names. You should apply Base 3 style for Base 3 layer, and Glass 1 style for Glass 1 layer, and so on. Now we are on Base 3 layer. We should select the base 3 style, then click OK. And this is the result. Now hide base 3 and unhide glass 1. Double click it to open its layer style. Select glass 1 style, then click OK. Repeat again with the next layer. Just keep doing this until you finish all layers. For further understanding, you can check how each layer style has been made. Now, let's speed that a little bit. Select all layers, then collapse one to collapse all of them. Well, let's unhide all layers to see our final result. Great! Let's move on to the next step. Step 3. Add glow and adjustments. Now, select the main layer, then press Ctrl J to duplicate it once. Unhide it. Then go to Filter, Blur and choose Gaussian Blur. Change radius to 20 pixels, then click OK. Now we will duplicate this layer 5 times. And for each layer, we are going to change the blur value, the blending mode, and the opacity. With your layer selected, press Ctrl+J 5 times. With your first layer selected, hold Shift and select the last layer to group all 6 layers. Name the group Glow. Open it and hide the top 5 layers. Let's start adjusting layer by layer. For the first layer, leave blur value 20. Change blend mode to color and change opacity to 50%. Let's unhide the second layer. Double-click the Gaussian blur filter and change it to 120 pixels. Change blend mode to screen and change opacity to 50%. Unhide the third layer. Change blur to 90. Blend mode to lighten. And opacity to 50. Unhide the fourth layer. Change blur to 300 with a lighten blend mode and 50% opacity. And for the fifth layer, change blur to 450 pixels, blend mode to divide, and opacity to 80%. And for the final one, it's 450 pixels with vivid light and 80%. And that's it. Now let's add some adjustment layers. Just select the top group, then add a levels adjustment layer. Change both sliders to 20 and 235. This would make your image a little bit darker. Now create a brightness and contrast layer. Change brightness to 100 and contrast to 60. And finally, add a vibrance layer. Change vibrance to plus 15 and saturation to plus 35. With the top layer selected, hold the Shift key and select the third layer to group them. Name it Adjustments. Let's see the before and after. That's amazing. Let's move on to the final step. Step 4, add wires and update the text. Now, let's add some wires in the background to look more realistic. I've made a simple wire creator action. You can download it from the description below. Let's import our action from the Actions panel. Select it and click Load. Before running the action, please make sure that your brush has 100% opacity and flow, with a normal blend mode and 13 pixels in size. Now pick the pen tool and change it to path from here. Start drawing the wire path as you like. Hold Alt and click to break the pen tool handles. Now select the action and click on this little run icon. Drag the created layer under the Glow folder. Create another one if you like. Then group both of them like that. Name it Wires. Now let's update the final effect with anything we want. First, double-click on the main layer's thumbnail to open it. Now we are inside our smart object. Change text to anything you like. Then press Ctrl+S to update it. Whatever shape or text you add in there will be converted into a neon effect with its own colors. Why? Because all smart layers here are connected together as they're copies of each other. Once you update one of them, all other layers will get the same update. Now let's draw some shapes. Just select the pen tool and make sure that you're drawing a shape, not a path, with no fill and with a solid color stroke. Change stroke size to 55 pixels. start drawing whatever you like. Please make sure that you are drawing a rounded caps with rounded corners. And also, make sure that the width of any shape or text is 55 to 58 pixels. Draw another shape and don't make any contact between them. Now press Ctrl S to update your neon effect. Get back to your main document, and that's it. Please like the video and subscribe for more free tutorials. And leave a comment below if you need any help. Thanks for watching.